Go further with Dropbox. Once you've mastered the basics, there's much more you can do. One of its most useful features is sharing, and you can easily send links to files, folders, and albums to others, allowing access with controls or permissions. You can also create shared folders. Others can join when invited, the folder appears inside their Dropbox, and content they place into it is automatically synced. You can see how handy this would be, working on projects with people over the internet. No need to email files, just a synced folder. When you collaborate, several people may open and work on a single document. Dropbox supports versioning. As a new version of a file is saved and synced, it keeps both the old and new versions, and you can access or restore any version at any time. And if someone accidentally deletes a file, that's no problem either. Synced items that you remove from your local Dropbox folder or manually delete from your main file list on the Dropbox website are not fully deleted from Dropbox's servers. They just disappear from your listing and are removed from your computer's storage. They can be restored unless you choose to permanently delete them. How to share, collaborate, and recover deleted files. Share a file. The main file list in your Dropbox web account provides a way to send a link to any file easily. Click once on a file to highlight it, and a link appears in the toolbar at the top of the file list that performs the same action, or simple double-click on a file, and a drop-down list appears. Click to open in web view, and then you can share as content. Copy items. You can copy any item inside Dropbox without downloading it. Right-click on an item in the file list and select copy. You're prompted to choose a destination folder into which the item is duplicated. Email the link. Click share at the top of the screen and a window opens where you can enter the email addresses of recipients as well as adding an optional message. Facebook and Twitter buttons let you post the link to your social media account. Click Send or click Get Link to copy the link to the clipboard. Create new folder. To share multiple files, group them into a folder first. Click on the New Folder button in the toolbar at the top and name your folder. Then select the items in the list that you want. To select multiple items, click the first, then Command-click on Mac, or Control-click on PC, and select any others you want, then drag them into the new folder. Share the folder. Select your new folder in the main file list and right-click on it. This is another way to share an item using the contextual menu. In this same menu, you can also rename or move it to any other location within your Dropbox account. Collaborate on a folder. To create a collaborative folder, right-click on it in the list and select Invite to Folder. Again, add recipient's details plus an optional message. You can also allow the recipient to invite others, or not if you want to keep it private. The folder appears in their Dropbox account. View versions of a file. If you open and modify a file in your Dropbox folder, the updated version is synced to the cloud. If you right-click on the file on the Dropbox website and select Previous Versions, you see all available versions from newest to oldest, as well as who uploaded it and when it was synced. Restore a previous version. Go to your folder, right-click on a file, and click on Previous Versions. From the versions list, you can select any previous version and restore it by clicking Restore. Now the version shown in your main file list is the one you selected. If you look at the previous versions list again, you see nothing has been overwritten, everything remains available. Restore a deleted file. If you've deleted a synced file from your Mac or from Dropbox, it hasn't actually gone. Click the trash can icon at the top of the main file list to show deleted files, Then right-click on a deleted file and choose Restore to undelete it, or you can choose Permanently Delete to get rid of it, for good. Versioning means storing different versions of any file. If you're working on, say, a Word document, you may make lots of changes over time. If they are being synced, Dropbox stores each version and lets you access them all. I hope this video was helpful, and if so, leave a comment, hit the like button and
subscribe.